Hey, hello everyone, and welcome back once again to Unity of Command 2. We're playing the Stalingrad DLC with Disaster on the Don, January 13th, 1943. It's New Year's Day, 1943. For the Axis, the situation on the Eastern Front worsens by the hour. Buoyed by the recent strings of victories, the Red Army launches yet another offensive into an increasingly rickety Axis front line. This time it's the turn of the Hungarians and Italians to bear the full brunt of a Soviet offensive. The Voronezh Front aims to destroy the Italian 8th and Hungarian 2nd Armies, after which follow-up operations will strike at Voronezh and beyond. At this stage, the Germans have little left with which to support their hard-pressed allies. We need to save the Hungarians. Of course, right after linking up with the 6th Army. It's going to be interesting. Soviets are about to hit our Italian and Hungarian allies hard. You must hold on as long as possible while trying to keep these forces intact. Be warned, this may prove an impossible task as if they have no real counter to heavy Soviet armored formations. Should our allies break, our own 2nd Army will be left completely exposed in Voronezh. Under such circumstances, you're authorized to fall back to the Oskol River. We cannot afford the loss of another army. Story Oskol, Navi Oskol, and Tukursk have to be held, and then Ostrogoshk till start of turn 4, Voronezh entire mission, Kastornu till turn 4, and Rossoh by turn 3. And we have to save the Hungarians. So we cannot beat them across the river here, potentially here. That's quite good. Two and two. I thought they had a 100% retreat chance. They'll get out of there now. Okay, so that should help somewhat. Let's actually get rid of you. I might get rid of the ninth light entirely too, but I'm thinking I'm gonna that cannot be the case. They're 265. They can take at least one more step. They'll be a lot better. I would rather reorganize them than them. I still have one at that point. Okay. I can destroy a bridge, which can be pretty useful. If I destroy that, That should delay them. Okay, that's pretty much all I can do. In those terms. So, out here. Problem is that those Katyushas are still gonna be nasty. They get to hold out. I'll do that. Now the main difficulty I think is also getting quite a bunch of those Italian units out, or Hungarian units. So if I destroy that bridge, they still have this bridge here, but it's harder to reach. It's fine. In here, things are also going to be quite tricky, so as it stands, crap, they're gonna be back. I'll sacrifice them. So what I can do, by throwing them the bone of dealing with that, they'll likely just kill these. Not too sure how they're gonna handle that then. And they're just generally reinforcing for now. No reason indeed to have an additional supply hub there. That one is quite necessary. We're also getting a bunch of reinforcements. Completely forgot about that hex too. Crap. Wow. Okay. They aren't retreating, huh? No, they are. That makes them look a little bit less weak, and the great thing is that now by telling them I'm gonna destroy those two down bridges, I need a lot less forces in here and I can actually help out down there. Yeah, I definitely want them to dig in there. We'll get a group of Fegelein out. And these guys in here, they'll very likely focus their attacks on them. And I don't want them to be able to cross and then immediately attack. So I'm actually sacrificing quite a lot here. Huh? Which Italians are lost? What? Which Italians did I lose? Or Hungarians? Where did I lose them? Must have been down there, if that counted. Because I don't remember losing any other potential steps, actually. These are Italians, so that would be really weird. What the heck? Okay. Just gonna have to assume that that's the problem. It would be rather ridiculous if it was the Italians being lost and I still lost steps. Because then there's basically no way you're getting this objective if the Italians, etc. also count. Okay. These guys are a problem. So, what I need to do... First of all, I do need you to get out. And these are also part of that. This is something I most certainly will do. The thing is that ideally... Oh, that's an 0-2 as well. That's nice, but I kind of need to weaken them a bit first. If it's a 4, it's okay, yeah. But then they cannot move. Interesting. Really happy about that overrun too, because it means I can get them back. Now at least I've beaten back the artillery unit. That certainly helps. I can no longer blow that bridge. But... blowing this bridge is also not necessarily the best thing. Not forest terrain, unfortunately. If I could place a German song there, I would very gladly reinforce those there too. I'll keep them there. Let's hope that keeps it safe. No luck, eh? If I move down, they're gonna lose that ability. But it's not so bad. I'm gonna take over one step from them. Because I want to put it on the 57th Infantry. Yeah, that attack is not good enough. And I also need to prepare the Hungarian army. Losing some of this is fine. The Hungarian army needs to move down. I can't keep it in Ostrogoshk either. Yeah, I have to do this too. Any units that might still be left there. At that point, now get it from that position. Didn't do anything here. Should be fine. This is fine, this is fine. And this also strengthens this area a bit. let's actually move you to Kostornu. No reinforcements yet. Okay. Crud. Uh-oh. Wow. Also, wow. Uh-oh. Please retreat? No. Seeing that Katyusha there is also a bit of a problem. Okay, the one thing that's now interesting at least is I can abandon Rosoch, because it's now turn 3. The next one is Kostornu and Ostrogoshk, which I still have to hold for one turn. This is really sucky. I'm surprised they did get mauled so badly. Well, not that surprised, but they'll be out of supply for one turn. That's a pity. One, two, three, four. The tricky, well, I can actually get these into Kursk before they'd get in. So I can save that, technically. That can be a reasonable block. Where would I have used air supply? I'm quite sure I had two. Didn't use it on them. Both of those are part of Armies. It's not so much a problem. Crap. Can't allow them to go and cross from there either. That pretty much means the end of those guys. If I want to take away their Stug, I can replace it. Probably a good idea, despite me then not being able to do a whole lot in there. allow them to kill it. That would be it for turn three. Okay. I'm fairly disappointed by my meager organization there. Okay, so I held both Ostrogorsk and Kostornu for a long enough period of time. At least. Wow, there's no supply from there. That's the only thing, huh? That's pretty harsh. But what, I am for sure going to do. Is block all of them off. So they'll be out of supply for a second turn. And them too, so that at least these guys cannot attack. The thing I think is really necessary is the beating of these. So as much as I'd wanna defend, I'll do that, and then hopefully they're not going to be able to move all the way in there again. The thing is, I really need to dig these guys in, or start digging them in. In need of evacuating them out too. Where did I lose more Hungarians? I also, this is the second time I have no clue where I supposedly lost. Maybe it's like steps, but where? Where did I supposedly lose more Hungarian steps? Like, it is so weird. I have no clue what I'm doing wrong and I'm losing these steps. Like, why? So that's another mystery. Super weird. I'll get you in supply though. It's probably the best thing I can do. Sad as it is, I'm also gonna have to give up the 223rd. Where are you guys showing up there? Across Deutschland there. If I can restore supply, that might help, but I currently cannot. Try to allow them to take it, but then not go too far. Thank you. Technically, a lot of these could still be in supply, which is, I also think, pretty interesting. Them holding here has worked at least reasonably well for that. Of course I have to hold Voronezh for even longer, and that's going to be very tricky to do now as well. Seems to be like I can once again get a significant portion of those units out of supply by beating this unit. Come on. Gotta be freaking kidding me. So now, because basically everything hinges on that, because I can now not do this, all of them will be in supply simply because those rolls were bad. That's really, really harsh. And really sucky too. Man, fuck that. They still move that way, huh? Well, you're dead. Could they move in there then? No, they cannot. That makes things a lot trickier there too. I think they could hold for another turn. Man, screw that. I think I would have been so golden would I have been able to cut those guys off again. I'm actually gonna move this way. Cutting me off again. Nice. Now, I do think I'll have to hold for one more turn. So Getting both of those out of supply doesn't really help me. What I want to do is I want to disrupt them here as much as possible during these upcoming turns. So that's why I'm doing that. This is fine. I think given that I'll be blocking these now, they can try to go in there, but I think they'll be handily blocked. I'm gonna attack here, because what I'm gonna do is you're gonna move in here. I'm basically gonna move all of those back, just put these in place. 57th Infantry is also gonna come back. But now I can move you in there. You ain't coming back. Just move it here. I'm likely gonna blow both of those bridges, so at the very least they also cannot get there. I think I can leave these if I dig them in. Just really blocking this with the zone of control as well. So they have a lot of trouble getting to Novyoskol in their final turn. 1, 2, 3, 4. They cannot attack either of those. I don't really care about losses here too much. I just want to make sure that they are unable to attack. Same here. The losses are unimportant. I'll do that. They can't attack at that point anymore. didn't blow the bridge, but I think I'll be fine. They had to use those. There's no way they're taking Voronezh now. The Soviets are taking huge attrition losses too. Even though the Soviets are technically still advancing, I would also say that look at those losses, insane. I would also say that we've kind of stabilized the situation. Yeah, we would have lost Voronezh, obviously, but I think we'll be able to start counterattacking from here. Given, I mean, look at those losses. 50% of the Italians are dead. And we lost 25% in German losses as well. Absolutely crazy. But I got all the objectives. And that's what counts. Also, none of those units were going to come back. So, that's okay. It seems always a little bit tricky to... when you see those kind of odds, it's really, really nuts. Anyway, I'll be wrapping things up. Wanted to thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please do consider leaving a like, comment, or subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next one. Take care. See you then. Bye-bye.